Okay, continuing the little motorcycle gear series here, we'll move on to helmets and gloves. Helmets, I'm not going to say much about them other than the fact that, for the love of God, wear one. And for two, I want to show you that you can get into them fairly cheap and still get good protection. I'm not going to mention any manufacturers' names or anything because that's just wrong to promote any, you know, names and stuff. So, you know, and I'm certainly not going to show which helmet I prefer or wear. But anyway, this helmet, it was my first helmet. You'll note it's neutral, so that if I get a different colored bike, it will work. It, as you can see, is certainly protective. It fits really well, but it didn't cost me much. I went to an indoor go-kart track, and they had a sale, and it was $75. A lot of helmets are usually in the $150 to $700 even sometimes. Excuse me. Cost for these things. I just want to show that a lot of times when you go out to a motorcycle shop, you see those expensive helmets, and it's when I was first getting into riding, I thought, oh my God, I'm going to have to spend so much on gear, and that's part of why I'm making this series, so you can see that you can get good protection, as you saw from the rating on the back of this, compared to my new helmet, which this is a $150 helmet. And again, I won't give away any manufacturer's name or anything. I won't show any favoritism. But I really like this helmet. I asked for it for Christmas last year. And, you know, again, the difference here is, well, why didn't you get that one first? Well, it wasn't out then, for one thing. But for two, when I was first getting into riding, this is kind of like buying a used bike. You can, this fell and has been knocked around a while, and it's not making me cry if it gets scratched, whereas the new one would have. So once I got a little experience with that helmet, I then got a nicer one, and you know, again, my initial costs for getting into riding were a little less, and yet you'll note the protection is the same. So, you can get a decent helmet without breaking the bank. Now, I will say that the more expensive helmet fits a little snugger, and that's kind of nice. That's another thing. When you try helmets on, you put them on, shake your head around. You don't want that helmet shaking too much. It shouldn't be flopping around at all. You want it to stay where it is because the helmet's designed to protect your head. Also want to say something about visors. Helmets, you can get interchangeable visors so you can have sun protection. I do not like doing that. I like wearing sunglasses, and I'll tell you why. When you're riding, it's hard to store a giant windscreen from a helmet. Much easier to store your sunglasses. In my opinion. And I like to travel on the bike, so that saves up some room. So when it gets dark out, I can just take my sunglasses off and continue to ride. And it takes less time, too. So, anyway, you know, I know you're thinking, well, that wasn't that much information, but hey, what guy doesn't want to show off his helmet? Huh? Yeah. Okay. Then we'll move on to gloves. Now, gloves, this is going to kind of suck because my gloves are not the best as far as protection goes. These are kind of regular motorcycle gloves, and they do offer knuckle protection and all that, but as you can see, they're very, and finger protection. They have very nice grips. I can actually use the throttle on the bike without even having my hand closed. Those little nubs grip really well, and they allow a lot of movement. You know, my hand is easily moved, which is comfortable. And you have to think about comfort a little bit as well as protection. Plus, again, the price was right. You'll see a lot of gloves that go for $150 if they have a lot of protection, which is good to have a lot of protection, but again, these were what I got when I first started riding, and they kept the cost down, and they do give me protection. Now, not as much protection as I could have, probably. Some gloves will have big carbon fiber knuckle protection and finger protection. And also, these gloves end at the end of my hand. There is a glove called the gauntlet style glove, which is longer and goes further down your wrist to protect your wrist more. I tend to secure my jacket, has a Velcro thing that I secure right around the end of this glove, though. Of course, that doesn't mean if you were to slide down the road, it would still pull the sleeve up and leave my wrist vulnerable. And that's true. You are better off with as far as protection goes, you're better off with a gauntlet-style glove. However, there's something to be said about comfort, and I don't like how those feel. And these are very dexterous, is the word, which is just means that you can move your fingers and use your fingers much easier. They're not real heavy. They don't get hot. They're very well vented. Yet I actually, to help retain heat on a colder day, I got some very cheap $1, they're only a dollar, gloves from Walmart to slip on under these, which these are fairly adjustable with the Velcro strip. They have two secures. You see the Velcro and the snap. And they only cost me $25. So I thought it was a pretty good compromise between safety and cost and comfort, which is all you have to take into account. And they're neutral, so they'll go with any color bike. And I realize some of you are probably thinking the irony that I'm waving my hand around so much during these videos after making a video about random hand gestures, but I have to do that because otherwise this video would be even more boring than it already is. At least you've got this to watch, you know, what we're doing, because otherwise it's just, oh, wow, gloves, look, ooh, helmet. Of course, again, what guy doesn't want to show off his helmet? This poor helmet now is regulated to just decoration. But anyway, if you have any questions, please feel free to post and or send a message, and I'll be glad to help all I can.